So we have said that respiration is a process in which energy is released in the body from assimilated food. So this respiration is completed in a body in two steps. The first step is body level, at body level, and second one is cellular level. Now body level includes only two steps that you know very well, and you also studied in detail about the respiratory system. So the two steps which takes place at body level are inhalation and exhalation, means exchange of gases. We take oxygen from the air and give out carbon dioxide from the body. So this exchange of gases takes place at the body level. And second one is cellular level, means actually energy releasing process takes place here at the cellular level. Means you in the cell, every cell of the body, there are mitochondria, and you know that these are called as powerhouse of the cell. Now why they are called powerhouse? Power means energy. So actually energy is released in the mitochondria, and this step takes place, that is cellular level, which occurs here in mitochondria. So now we will see in detail about how respiration occurs at body level and at the cellular level. So here, you know respiratory system, you have studied it, that it includes nostrils, nasal cavity, larynx, trachea, and bronchi, and the main important respiratory organs are lungs. So what happens at body level? Inhalation and exhalation of gases, means oxygen is inhaled. Now how we can say that oxygen is inhaled? Now actually we do not inhale oxygen, we inhale the air, but only oxygen from that air is absorbed in the blood, and then blood carries it to different parts of our body, each and every cell of the body. So here air enters through the nostrils, then it passes through larynx, trachea, bronchi, and then to the lungs. And you know that again the important organ, that is diaphragm. Diaphragm, do you remember what is diaphragm? A muscular fold which is present between the chest cavity and abdominal cavity. In between these two cavities, this muscular fold is present, which is called as diaphragm. And contraction and relaxation of this diaphragm helps in inhalation and exhalation of oxygen and carbon dioxide. Now when this diaphragm contracts, what happens? The thoracic volume of thoracic cavity increases. So air is inhaled. Air pressure inside the lungs decreases, air is inhaled. And then oxygen from that air is absorbed in the blood. When this diaphragm relaxes, when it contracts like this. Ashi khali contract hote, manun thoracic cavity's volume vadto. Lungs matla air pressure kami hoto, and we inhale the air from atmosphere. But when this diaphragm, see here, look at this. This diaphragm relaxes. Ki relax hali keshi var jate, contract hali keshi khali jate. When it relaxes, what happens? The volume of thoracic cavity decreases, air pressure inside the lungs decreases, and air is expelled out. So through this air, we expel carbon dioxide. So in this way, at body level, exchange of gases takes place. Means oxygen from the air is absorbed in the blood, and carbon dioxide from the blood is released in the air, in the lungs. And which part of the lungs help actually in this exchange of gases? So these are alveoli. You may remember this name. Alveoli, these are nothing but the balloon-like structure present inside the lungs. Each bronchiole ends into this balloon-like structure, which is called as alveoli. And in these alveoli, these are richly supplied with blood vessels. And so blood is present in these alveoli, and in that the hemoglobin in that blood absorbs the oxygen from the air that we inhale, and from that blood carbon dioxide is given out into the alveoli, and from it is expelled out by using all these respiratory organs. So in this way actually exchange of gases takes place, that is inhalation and exhalation takes place at the body level. It is a simple physical process. Now we are going to study about the second step, that is cellular respiration. Second step is cellular respiration. Now during this cellular respiration, in each and every cell of the body, in mitochondria of every cell of the body, glucose is oxidized, means glucose combines with oxygen, and then oxidation reaction takes place, to release carbon dioxide, water and energy. This energy is released in the form of a chemical compound called as adenosine triphosphate, that is ATP. In short, we call it as ATP, means adenosine triphosphate. So main respiratory substrate is glucose. Remember it for objective. The fill in the blank can be asked that the dash respiratory system is used during respiratory substrate is used in respiration. Respiratory substrate is the substance which releases energy. So in our body, glucose is the main substance which releases energy. It undergoes oxidation, combines with oxygen and releases carbon dioxide, water and energy. Energy is released in the form of ATP, that is used for all our life processes, and here carbon dioxide is expelled out. Now look at this glucose. It consists of 6 molecules, 6 atoms of carbons, then 12 atoms of hydrogen and 6 atoms of oxygen. C6H12O6. It undergoes oxidation, combines with oxygen, releases 6 molecules of carbon dioxide, 6 molecules of water and energy, which is stored in the body in the form of ATP. So ATP is called as energy currency of the body, because in our body energy is utilized only in the form of ATP, adenosine triphosphate. Now we are going to study how this actually reaction occurs. How direct here we can write C6H12O6 plus 6O2 gives 6CO2 plus H2O plus energy. But this is not so simple process. This total oxidation process is carried out in 3 steps. In all living organism, you know, respiration occurs. But it is not similar in all type of living organism. In some microorganisms, it is different than the higher animals. So respiration is of 2 types, aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. Aerobic means here, you know, you can clearly see glucose combines with oxygen and then releases energy. Means here the respiration in which energy is released by using oxygen or in presence of oxygen, that respiration is called as aerobic respiration. And in some lower animals, in some bacteria, the oxygen is not necessary to release energy from the glucose. So energy releasing process takes place in absence of oxygen. So that type of respiration is anaerobic respiration. So now we will see how this glucose is oxidized completely to release energy in aerobic respiration. It occurs in 3 steps. So see how this aerobic respiration occurs. Means respiration which takes place in higher animals, including human beings also. We have seen that in this process, in aerobic respiration, energy is released in presence of oxygen. Means oxygen is necessary. Glucose undergoes oxidation, means combined with oxygen, and then energy is released. But this energy releasing process is completed in 3 steps. The first step of aerobic respiration is glycolysis. It is called as glycolysis. Second one is Krebs cycle, or it is also called TCA cycle. Then third one is called as electron transfer chain reaction. So these are the 3 steps in which aerobic respiration gets completed and energy is released. First step is glycolysis. Second one is Krebs cycle. And third one is electron transfer chain reaction. Now we are going to study about the first step, glycolysis. What happens during glycolysis? Now you can clearly understand the meaning. Glycolysis. Glyco, this word is for glucose. And lysis means splitting or breaking. So in the first step, glycolysis occurs, means the splitting of glucose molecule takes place. So what is that splitting? How, in which compounds it get broken down, that we are going to study. So glycolysis is the first step. Now see what happens during glycolysis. So the first step is glycolysis. First step of aerobic respiration is glycolysis. Means splitting of glucose molecule occurs in presence of oxygen. Now here see, this glucose molecule, it splits up or breaks up to form 2 molecules of pyruvic acid, then 2 molecules of NADH2 and 4 molecules of ATP. And it is in triphosphate, that is energy. occurs into two molecules of pyruvic acid, two molecules of NADH2 and four molecules of ATP. Again, these two molecules of pyruvic acid gets converted into two molecules of acetyl coenzyme A. Acetyl coenzyme A, because these two pyruvic acid molecule, they combines with an enzyme. Many, you know that during digestion, many enzymes are helpful, which carry out the digestion of food in our body. Similarly, during respiration also some enzymes are used. So that is the first enzyme, coenzyme A, which reacts with this pyruvic acid and forms two molecules of acetyl coenzyme A, two molecules of carbon dioxide and two molecules of NADH2. So remember that what happens during glycolysis, a six carbon compound glucose first gets converted into three carbon compound pyruvic acid. So two molecules of pyruvic acid are formed, then these two molecules of pyruvic acid again gets converted into two molecules of acetyl coenzyme A, two molecules of carbon dioxide and two molecules of NADH2. Clear now? What is glycolysis? First, glucose gets converted into two molecules of pyruvic acid, then two molecules of pyruvic acid again gets converted into two molecules of acetyl coenzyme A and two molecules of carbon dioxide and two molecules of NADH2. Yes, you can explain glycolysis only in these two lines. So what is glycolysis or first step of aerobic respiration? During glycolysis, glucose molecule splits up into two molecules of pyruvic acid. Then these two molecules of pyruvic acid are converted into two molecules of acetyl coenzyme A, two molecules of carbon dioxide and two molecules of NADH2. So the first step is over. Now the second step is Krebs cycle. Now see what happens during this Krebs cycle. So I told you that cellular respiration takes place with the help of different types of enzymes. So two main enzymes which are used in this respiration are or coenzyme, that is we have seen NADH2. We have seen as a result of glycolysis what happens, two molecules of NADH2 are formed. So this, what is this NADH2? It is nothing but coenzyme. NAD plus and NADH2 plus. Its long form is nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide. Nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide. NADH. N nicotinamide, A for adenine, D for dinucleotide. NAD. Nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide. And second enzymes are FAD means or FADH2, flavin adenine dinucleotide. Nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, flavin adenine dinucleotide or flavin mononucleotide or nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, P means phosphate. So NADP or NADH2 or FAD or FADH2, these are the coenzymes which are used during cellular respiration to release energy in the mitochondria. Now see the second step. So the second step is now Krebs cycle, or it is also called as tricarboxylic acid cycle, in short TCA, tricarboxylic acid cycle. It was first discovered by the scientist Hans Krebs, therefore it is also called as Krebs cycle. So we have seen what happens during glycolysis. We have seen glucose molecule oxidizes to form two molecules of pyruvic acid, two molecules of NADH2 and four molecules of ATP. And then again these two molecules of pyruvic acid are converted into two molecules of acetyl coenzyme A, two molecules of carbon dioxide and two molecules of NADH2. Now what happens during this Krebs cycle? These two molecules of acetyl coenzyme A again undergoes completely oxidation. Here the acetyl part of coenzyme A undergoes oxidation and releases carbon dioxide, NADH2, FADH2 and ATP energy. So see what are the products of this Krebs cycle. During Krebs cycle, acetyl part of coenzyme A, acetyl coenzyme A undergo oxidation and forms carbon dioxide, 2 molecules of ATP and 6 molecules of NADH2 and 2 molecules of FADH2. That is the second step, Krebs cycle. Understand? Samajla? Pahila step madhe apan pahila glycolysis madhe kay hota? Glucose molecule first breaks to form 2 molecules of pyruvic acid, then again 2 pyruvic acid undergoes oxidation to form 2 molecules of acetyl coenzyme A, 2 molecules of carbon dioxide and 2 molecules of NADH2, that is glycolysis. Now second step is Krebs cycle. During Krebs cycle, these molecules of acetyl part of coenzyme, acetyl coenzyme A undergoes oxidation. हा जो एसिटिल कोएंजाइम ए आहे याच्यातला एसिटिल पार्टचं काय होऊन जातं, ऑक्सिडेशन होतं आणि हा एन्झाइम जशाला तसा राहतो, हा परत दुसऱ्या वेळेस यूज केला जातो. सो हियर एसिटिल पार्ट ऑफ कोएंजाइम ए अंडरगोज ऑक्सिडेशन अँड फॉर्म्स 4 मॉलिक्युल्स ऑफ कार्बन डायऑक्साइड, 2 मॉलिक्युल्स ऑफ एटीपी, 6 मॉलिक्युल्स ऑफ एनएडीएच2 अँड 2 मॉलिक्युल्स ऑफ एफएडीएच2. दॅट इज द क्रेब्स सायकल. नाउ द थर्ड स्टेप, इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रान्सफर चेन रिएक्शन. सो द थर्ड स्टेप इज इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रान्सफर चेन रिएक्शन. वी हैव सीन इन द फर्स्ट स्टेप इज ग्लायकोलिसिस, सेकंड स्टेप इज क्रेब्स साइकल, एंड ड्यूरिंग बोथ दीज स्टेप्स एनएडीएच एंड एफएडीएच2 आर रिलीज, मीन्स निकोटिनामाइड एडिनाइन डायफॉस्फेट and flavin adenine diphosphate, these enzymes are released. So during this third step, electron transfer chain reaction, what happens, these NADH2, each molecule of NADH2 gives 3 molecules of ATP. Eka NADH2 molecule madun kiti ATP nikta? 3 ATPs. And one molecule of FADH2 gives 2 molecules of ATPs. So in this way, the energy releasing process occurs from NADH2 and FADH2 in this third step, electron transfer chain reaction. So look at this complete aerobic respiration process. The first step is glycolysis, in which we have seen during glycolysis, glucose breaks down to form 2 molecules of pyruvic acid. 2 molecules of pyruvic acid are again converted into 2 molecules of acetyl coenzyme A and 2 ATP molecules are released during glycolysis. Only 2 ATP molecules are released during glycolysis. The second step is Krebs cycle. During Krebs cycle, we have seen that acetyl part of coenzyme A undergoes oxidation and releases carbon dioxide, NADH2 and FADH2. So see here, this carbon dioxide. And during third step, that is electron transfer chain reaction, the NADH2 molecule releases ATP, each FADH2 molecule also releases 2 molecules of ATP. One molecule of NADH2 releases 3 molecules of ATP and one molecule of FADH2 releases 2 molecules of ATP. मग पहिल्या स्टेपमध्ये किती NADH2 रिलीज झाले, दुसऱ्या स्टेपमध्ये किती NADH2 आणि FADH2 रिलीज झाले, त्या प्रत्येक एका NADH2 पासून 3 ATP निघतात आणि प्रत्येक एका FADH2 पासून 2 ATP निघतात. असे इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रान्सफर चेन रिएक्शन मध्ये 36 ATP मॉलिक्युल्स रिलीज होतात आणि वॉटर मॉलिक्युल रिलीज होतात. सो या ETC मध्ये रिलीज झालेले 36 ATP आणि फर्स्ट ग्लायकोलिसिस मध्ये रिलीज झालेले 2 ATP, असे टोटल 38 ATP मॉलिक्युल्स आर रिलीज व्हेन वन ग्लुकोज मॉलिक्युल अंडरगोज ऑक्सिडेशन ड्यूरिंग रेस्पिरेशन, एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन. कळलं? म्हणजे एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन मध्ये जेव्हा फक्त एक ग्लुकोज मॉलिक्युल ऑक्सिडाइज होतो तेव्हा टोटल हे 2 प्लस ते 36, टोटल किती मॉलिक्युल्स रिलीज झाले एनर्जीचे, 36 ATP मॉलिक्युल्स, कार्बन डायऑक्साइड, वॉटर. सो कार्बन डायऑक्साइड, वॉटर अँड 38 ATP मॉलिक्युल्स मीन्स रिली एनर्जी. सो इन दिस वे ऑक्सिडेशन ऑफ द ग्लुकोज टेक्स प्लेस. वन ग्लुकोज मॉलिक्युल्स रिलीजेस 38 ATP मॉलिक्युल्स. एका ग्लुकोज मॉलिक्युल मधून 38 ATP एनर्जी, मॉलिक्युल एनर्जी रिलीज होते ड्यूरिंग एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन. सो दिस एनर्जी इज व्हेरी हाय बिकॉज ऑल हायर एनिमल्स डू मोर अँड मोर फिजिकल ऍक्टिव्हिटीज, सो दे ऑल्सो नीड मोर अँड मोर एनर्जी. सो फ्रॉम ऑक्सिडेशन ऑफ वन ग्लुकोज मॉलिक्युल 38 ATP molecules are released. So now get about this aerobic respiration. Remember, it is aerobic. What is aerobic respiration? Respiration in which energy is released in presence of oxygen. That is called as aerobic respiration. Second one, it is completed into three steps: glycolysis, Krebs cycle, and ETC, means electron transfer chain reaction. Now what happens during glycolysis? Glucose molecule first oxidizes to form two molecules of pyruvic acid. Then two molecules of pyruvic acid again undergoes oxidation and form two molecules of acetyl coenzyme A. Then two molecules of ATP. Then during second step, during Krebs cycle, acetyl part of coenzyme A undergoes oxidation and releases carbon dioxide and again some amount of energy. And during the third, in both these steps, first and second, you have seen NADH2 and FADH2 molecules are also released. So here, these NADH2 and FADH2 molecule releases ATP during the third step, electron transfer chain reaction. Each molecule of NADH2 releases 3 ATP molecules and each molecule of FADH2 releases 2 ATP molecules. So in this way, as a result of oxidation of one glucose molecule in aerobic respiration, 38 ATP molecules are released. So that's all about aerobic respiration.